I'm Julie Durant and I'm Head of Secretarial Services at Baker & McKenzie. The strategic objective of taking on the apprentices for Baker & McKenzie was pretty clear for us. We get to develop our own homegrown talent. We have a talent pipeline of people we've trained up and who know how bakers like to do things. But more importantly, I think it follows our diversity and inclusion strategy. We are, as a firm, extremely committed to this. And inviting these apprentices on board does go some way for us to satisfy some of our aims in relation to diversity and inclusion. So for us, that is key. It's very important. I've been extremely happy with how the scheme has developed over the last 3 years. We've been very lucky with the apprentices we've had. Two of them are now PAs, and we hope to retain them for much longer. They have many ways to go now up the career ladder. We see different intakes every time, different personalities, and it's a joy to watch them develop as individuals and PAs within our firm. The main opportunities the firm is giving to the young people who are on the scheme is an opportunity to work in a place like Baker & McKenzie. We're a global law firm. Perhaps they wouldn't get those opportunities normally, and this is a way in for them to start their careers doing something perhaps that they thought was out of reach for them at one point. The benefits for us of taking in apprentices rather than perhaps the normal recruitment route very much lies around us able to train them in ways that will further their own careers, but also further their careers with us. They won't have any bad habits yet gained from other employers. So for that reason alone, it's great. It also means we have an opportunity to take on people that we wouldn't normally see through our normal recruitment, you know, going through agencies or direct recruitment. So it's just a different way of attracting talent. I would recommend Silex Law School as the apprenticeship training advisor, because they have the knowledge that we don't have. And when we started out with the scheme 3 years ago, we needed that knowledge and guidance. So they're on hand, they tell us when we should be doing certain things, what we shouldn't be doing, you know, so we get the best out of our apprentices. So yes, they tick all those boxes. The advice I would give a firm who's thinking of setting up an apprenticeship scheme is perhaps to talk to other firms who've started already. Understand the commitment that, as a firm, that you will need to make. It's very important that you're there to support the apprentices, that you have the right infrastructure in place, you can give them the right training. And also, more importantly, that you have PAs who are there to train them up and take responsibility. And it is a commitment, but it's very much a worthwhile commitment. So I would say do it. Why not?